Good morning, all of you. So now we are going to discussing the distance from a point P x1 comma y1 to the straight line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. In the direction having inclination theta. See once you see the distance from a point x1 comma y1 to the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 in the direction having inclination theta. That means c is not asking the distance in generally perpendicular distance. So if we didn't mention any direction having inclination theta like that, the distance means always you should consider the perpendicular distance. Otherwise, we have to follow this inclination theta. So, how it will be once you see here? So, this is the coordinate axis. Let us take this is the point P x1, y1 is here. Okay. This is the straight line. So, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So, this is the point. So, here we have to find out the distance from this point to this line in the direction having inclination theta. Generally, it is the perpendicular. Let us take. But he is not asking the perpendicular direction. He is asking in the inclination theta. In this direction, he is asking. So, it is theta. So, he is asking the distance between these two. That means, let us take this is some r. Okay? See, it is the point x1 comma y1. So this is the point x1 comma y1 lies on this right hand hand inclination theta. Then let us take what is the point here. This is the intersection point of this line and given line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay. So according to symmetric form, what you have? So x is equal to x1 plus or minus r cos theta, y is equal to y1 plus or minus r sin theta. So you take an into direction. So that means this point is nothing but x1 minus r cos theta, y1 minus r sin theta, this point. So this point satisfies this straight line. So here we have to find out the value of r, that is the distance from this point to this straight line. Okay, so how can you find out? If you substitute this point in this given line and simplify the r value, that means you make r as subject, that gives the distance from this point to this straight line in the direction theta. See here how it will be. Since x1 minus r cos theta, y1 minus r sin theta lies on ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Substitute here what you have, a into x1 minus r cos theta plus b into y1 minus r sin theta plus c is equal to 0. See, this implies what it is, ax1 minus r cos theta plus by1 plus minus br sin theta plus c is equal to 0. See, these two terms and the remaining terms transpose to right side. Then what we have? So, here we have minus ar cos theta minus br sin theta is equal to. So, all negative terms we will get minus ax1 minus by1 minus. So, all negative, take minus common from left side and minus common from right side. So, minus minus will get cancelled. So, we have and you can take r common from left side. Then, what you have? R of a cos theta plus b sin theta is equal to ax1 plus by1 plus c after taking minus common and cancel. And in left side I have taken r common. Okay, so this implies r is equal to ax1 plus by1 plus c by a cos theta plus b sin theta. So sometimes according to theta you may get cos and sin in the negative values. So to avoid and here when you substitute x1 comma y1 in the given equation, you may get negative value. So, to avoid the difference, distance is always should consider positive. So, to avoid the difference, with modulus. So, r is equal to modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c by a cos theta plus b sin theta. This is the formula. See how it will be. So the given equation, you substitute the point x1 comma y1, that is the numerator, and denominator will be, in the case of x comma y, substitute the sin theta and cos theta, that is a, so that is a cos theta plus b sin theta. That's enough. Don't take constant. So a cos theta plus b sin theta denominator. So this is the distance from the point to this right line in the direction having inclination theta. Okay, if I suppose if you want to find out the perpendicular distance, what is the formula? See next concept. The perpendicular distance, if he didn't mention anything, means there is perpendicular distance only. If he is asking distance also, perpendicular distance. The perpendicular distance from Px1 comma y1 to Ax plus By plus C is equal to 0 is. See here, the perpendicular distance means we have to find out this distance. This is, you need to find out. This length we need to find out. Let us take this is something. Okay? See, it is the inclination, theta. In the direction theta. Then, it will be the inclination. That means, in this direction, we have to find out. So, here, inclination is changes. So, direction is changing. So, that's why inclination also changes. So, because of we need to find out distance. Okay? So, something we have theta. Here also we have some theta, inclination. So, if this theta means it is also some theta. But here theta means you take some alpha, no problem. Whatever. So, here we have some inclination. So, let us say that is theta only. Okay? So, now, what is the slope of this line? If the inclination is theta, then slope will become to tan theta. Yes? So, slope is equal to what? Slope is equal to tan theta. In this formula only, from this formula only, we have to derive the distance, perpendicular distance from point to the given square. So, whenever it is the inclination theta, just this theta I am taking here. So, okay. So, this theta, that is slope is equal to tan theta, slope of this line. Okay. Slope of this line is tan theta means. So, according to this concept, this cos theta, sin theta, what it means? See here. Here it is the Ax plus By plus C is equal to 0. This is the line, straight line. What is the slope of this line? Minus A by, you know very well. Minus coefficient of X by, coefficient of what is the slope of this line. Otherwise, if you convert into slope, point slope form, then you get minus A by 1. Or slope intercept form, whatever you mean. So if you convert into slope, slope intercept form, you will get what is that? By is equal to minus ax minus c. So y is equal to minus a by bx minus c by b. So in the form of y is equal to mx plus c. So m is nothing but slope of this line. So here this is nothing but minus a by b. So slope of this line is minus a by b. Because of this line is perpendicular to this line, so if the slope of this line is m, the slope of this line becomes to minus 1 by b. Then what is the slope of this line? Slope is tan theta is equal to minus of 1 by minus a by b, that becomes to b by b. So tan theta is equal here b by a. So slope is tan theta is equal to b by a. So tan theta is equal to b by a means what is sin theta and cos theta? Same concept. So in this formula, cos theta, sin theta, substitute the original values in terms of a and b, you get the original formula of this one. Okay, so tan theta is equal to b by a. So tan theta b by a means it is a theta you take, this is the opposite side, this is the adjacent side. So, and hypotenuse is root of a square plus b square, you know very well. Then what it comes to sin theta is equal to a by root, sin theta is equal to b by root over a square plus b square, cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is a by root over a square plus b square. Now from this formula, that is r is equal to, now that is nothing but d. Here r change as d. So d is equal to what? D is equal to modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c by. So in denominator what you have a into cos theta means a by root over a square plus b square plus b into sin theta means b by root over a square plus b square. So this is nothing but what it is? Modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c by. So this is a square by root of a square plus b square by root of a square plus b square denominator is common root of a square plus b square only, the numerator add, so a square plus b square. So this is modulus. So this is k by some root k. K by root k means root k only. Okay, that is nothing but modulus of ax1 plus b by 1 plus c by root over a square plus b square. Because of a root over a square plus b square is always non-negative, so keep modulus. No need to write modulus. Okay, so this is the formula for distance between the point x1 comma y1 to the straight line. How it will be? Substitute x1 comma y1 in the equation that gives the numerator, keep the modulus and write root over a square plus b square. Coefficient of x, this is coefficient of y. Root over coefficient of x whole square plus coefficient of y whole square. That is root over a square plus b square. These two formulas are very, very important. Similarly, what is the distance from the pointer origin to the straight line? Distance from origin to straight line. So distance from 0 comma 0 to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. See, what is that? 0 comma 0 substitute in the given equation that gives the numerator, that is a into 0 plus b into 0 plus c by root power. Just to write root over a square plus b square. So it is nothing but a into 0, 0, b into 0, 0 plus c, that is c by root over a square plus b square, and keep the modulus here. Okay, next one, next concept is based on this one. The distance between two parallel lines. Distance between two parallel lines. Ax plus by plus c1 is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c2 is equal to 0. See, once you observe, parallel lines always differ by constants only. Remaining parts same to same you cover. Okay? So here first one constant is c1, second one constant you take 0. So is this formula is modulus of c1 minus c2 by root power a square plus b square. So why you may keep here modulus? So which one gives positive? We don't know. C1 minus C3 is positive or C2 minus C1 is positive, we don't know. So that's why keep the modulus. So whenever you keep the modulus, you can write the modulus of C2 minus C1 also, no problem. Modulus of C1 minus C2 by root over a square plus b square, modulus of C1 minus C2 by root over a square plus b square. Anyone you can write. See how you get this one. See, let us take the two lines ax plus by plus c1 is equal to 0, ax plus by plus c2 is equal to 0, these are the two lines. Let us take these two lines will be like this. These are the two parallel lines. Okay? See, how you get from one point on one line to another line, distance you find out, that is the distance between two parallel lines. Here, distance is perpendicular distance. How can you find out one point? Any one of the line. From any one of the line, you just find out one point. How it will be? See here, let us take first line is, or second line you take. On this line, what is the point? See here, if you convert into slope intercept form, then you get on x axis one point. Yes? So convert into slope intercept form or intercept form. How it will be? What is the x intercept and what is the y intercept? Take y is equal to 0, that gives x intercept. So y is equal to 0 in the second equation. So that is nothing but ax is equal to c minus c2, you get. So x is equal to minus c2 by a. That is the x intercept. This is the first line you take, this is the second line you take. So this is the second line, the point is nothing but minus c2 by a comma 0. Okay, from this point to this line, find out the perpendicular distance. This is the perpendicular distance, let us consider from this point. Okay, to the first line. What is the perpendicular distance? D is equal to, according to this formula, modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c by root over a square plus b square. Here, x1 comma y1 is nothing but minus c2 by a comma 0. Okay, so that is nothing but modulus of a into x1 plus, you substitute minus c2 by a, plus b into 0 plus c1 you write by root power a square plus b square. Here a is nothing but a only, b is nothing but b only. So root power a square plus b square. Simplify here, this is a get cancelled, b into 0, 0. So here minus c2 plus c1. That is nothing but modulus of c1 minus c2 by root power a square plus b square. Okay, very easy formula. So you just remember. So formula is modulus of the constants, difference of the constants. C1 minus C2 by root power a square plus b square. Next one is the equation of midway of the line, the equation midway of the line between two lines. Ax plus by plus c1 is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c2 is equal to 0. You understand by seeing these two lines, what can you understand? These two are parallel. Between these two parallel lines, he is asking to find out the midway line. That means how it will be? This is the first line. Let us take some ax plus by plus c1 is equal to 0. This is the second line, that is ax plus by plus c2 is equal to 0. So now we have to find out the equation of the line, that is the midway. Midway means that is going to middle point, but which is parallel to the given two lines. So let us take this line will be ax plus by plus k is equal to 0. Okay, so we have to find out this value of k in terms of c1 and c2. That is our required answer. Okay? See here, because of midway of these two lines, this one, distance between these two lines is nothing but distance between these two lines. Okay, apply the distance between the two parallel lines and apply the distance between these two parallel lines. So, this one, 1, 2, 3, you take 3 lines. So, here, distance between 1 comma 3 is equal to distance between 2 comma 3. So these are the parallel lines. So what can you conclude here? So C1 minus modulus of C1 minus this is the k. C1 minus k by root over a square plus b square is equal to here modulus of C2 minus k by root over a square plus b square. So both have same denominator with the cancel. So modulus of C1 minus K. So C1 minus K is equal to. So it is the mid one. So let us consider this is the upper one. So K minus C1 is the, that means C1 minus K is the positive here. C2 minus K is the negative because K is the big one. C2 is the small one. Let us consider that. Otherwise, you take whenever you have mod x is equal to mod y, x is equal to plus or minus y, you take. Okay, see here. Here I am taking c1 minus k is cos 2 way, and c2 minus k, instead of c2 minus k, I am taking k minus c, that will becomes to cos k minus c. So here, this c2 transpose this side, this k transpose this side. C1 plus c2 is equal to k plus k, that is 2k. So C1 plus C2 is equal to 2K means K is equal to how much? C1 plus C2 by. So required equation is nothing but what is that? AX plus BY plus K is equal to 0. That is the required equation. So instead of K, you substitute C1 plus C2 by. So this is very very important formula. The equation of the midway of the line between two lines AX plus BY plus C1 is equal to 0 and AX plus BY plus C2 is equal to 0. Is ax plus by plus c1 plus c2 by 2 is equal to 0. So next one. If the sum of the algebraic distances, if the sum of the algebraic distances from x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2, x3 comma y3 and so on, x1, xn comma y1, xn comma y1 to a line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is 0, that means the sum of the algebraic distances. Algebraic distances means perpendicular distance from x1 comma y1 to this line, x2 comma y2 to this line, x3 comma y3 to this line, and so on, xn comma y1 to this line. And all these sums if you take, that it becomes to 0, then what is saying? Then sigma xi comma sigma yi. That is, what is sigma xi, what is sigma yi? Here xi is how many are there? X1, x2 up to xn. Sigma means summation. So that is x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus and so on plus xn comma. This is the coordinate point. Y1 plus y2 plus y3 and so on plus yn lies on ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay, lies on ax plus c is equal to 0. This is how to. So what is asking? Sum of the algebraic distances from x1 comma y1 to the given line ax plus by plus c. What is that? So ax1 plus by1 plus c by root power a square plus b square. Summation, sum of the. So plus you take. And the distance from this point to this line, what is that? Ax2 plus by2 plus c by root power a square plus b square plus. Next, if you consider x3 comma y3 to distance, what is that? Ax3 plus by3 plus c by root power a square plus b square plus and so on plus. What is the last one? Xn comma yn. So what it is? Axn plus byn plus c by root power a square plus b square is equal to 0. If it is equal to 0, now we have to show this point lies on this line. Okay? See, simplify this one. What it is? In all denominators are same. So, and transpose that side, that gives 0. And numerator just to add. And here you take a comma from the terms which one have a. So a common, what you have, x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus and so on plus xn plus. Again b common, what it is, y1 plus y2 plus y3 plus and so on plus yn plus. What it is, how many c's are there? 1, 2, 3 up to how many are there? N are there. So that is cn is equal to 0. So here what we have to do, this is by n, sigma xi by n, sigma yi by n, that is here by n, here also by n. Okay, we have to do that. Okay, not a summation of xi, by n. Here how many are there, how many points are there, n points. Here how many points are there, n points, so just divide with n. So that is sigma xi by n, sigma yi by n, that means like this. So this is, we have the equation. A of x1 plus x2 plus and so on plus xn plus b of y1 plus y2 plus y3 plus and so on plus yn plus c into n, not cn, please. That is nc is equal to 0. So if your entire equation divide with n, how it will be once you see? That is a of x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus and so on plus xn by n plus b of y1 plus y2 plus and so on plus yn by n plus nc by c, that is c is equal to 0. So what can you conclude from this one? It is in the form of some ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. In the place of x, x1 plus x2 plus and so on plus xn by n, y1 plus y2 plus and so on yn by n. So that means what you can say? X1 plus x2 plus and so on plus xn by n, y1 plus y2 plus and so on plus yn by n lies on the given line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay, that means what you write, this is in the simplest form. Sigma xi by n plus b into sigma yi by n plus c is equal to 0. That means that is sigma xi by n comma sigma yi by n lies on ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That is the conclusion.